Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through mathematics form 3, lesson number 15. The topic it is the trigonometry 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modoni. Welcome. We are going to first of all look at the lesson goals. And the first lesson goal you are going to look at it is the trigonometric radius of negative angles using the unit circle. Then we also look at those trigonometric radius of the angles that are greater than 360 using the unit circle. We start looking at the angles, the trigonometric radius of just a mere angle that is 30 degrees, which is negative. You can be able to see where it is falling. For the negative angles, we are just taking the clockwise direction from x. As you can be able to see, where the angle negative 30 degrees is, it is where we are supposed to have the 330 degrees. That is the reason as to why we say that the trigonometric ratios of 30 degrees, trigonometric ratio, the difference is the positioning of the quadrant. In which quadrant is this angle negative 30 degrees? For example, when it is positive, it will fall in the first quadrant. Where when it is negative, you can get it is in the fourth quadrant. So, because it is in the fourth quadrant, you are going to get the properties of the fourth quadrant. That is, a cos being positive only is the one that we are going to take. But the trigonometric radius are similar to that of 30 degrees. But the difference is, when we talk about the cos 30 degrees, not cos 30 degrees, let's take cos negative 30 degrees. It's supposed to be then cos 30 degrees. They are supposed to be the same. But when I come to tan 30 degrees and tan negative 30 degrees, you are going to get tan negative 30 degrees is supposed to be negative of tan 30. That is what the way I'm supposed to take it when it comes to negative angles. Let us go briefly to what we'll be talking about, whatever I've talked about. In the unit circle, the negative angles start from OX, 0 degrees in the clockwise direction. This indicates that we start in the fourth quadrant, third quadrant, second quadrant, and the fourth quadrant. That is the way we move. Example, negative 64 degrees, negative 126 degrees, negative 228 degrees, and negative 315 degrees. That is what you want to represent. That is the way they are supposed to be. You can be able to see the negative 64 degrees, it is in the fourth quadrant. Where the negative 126 degrees, which is greater than negative 90 and less than negative 180, it is in the third quadrant. And then the other one, it is in the second quadrant. Then 315 degrees, which is greater than 270 negative, is in the first quadrant. You can be able to see that is an angle of 225 degrees negative. You can see it is in the position of the second quadrant where now we have that angle is greater than negative 180 degrees and less than 270 degrees. We have other examples. You can be able to see them. And today I want us to use the negative 64 degrees to get the trigonometric radius. Let us get them. For the trigonometric ratios of sine negative 64 degrees, it's supposed to be opposite over hypotenuse, which is equal to negative divided by the radius, while the cos negative 64 degrees is supposed to be the adjacent divided by the hypotenuse, which is equal to x divided by the radius. And tan negative 64 degrees is equals to the opposite divided by the adjacent, where now we get negative y divided by x. And in this case now, if I tell you are very keen, the fourth properties, the fourth quadrant properties are the ones that are taken. Only cos is positive, while tan and sine are negative. We have negative 116. You can be able to see we have the opposite of hypotenuse, which is negative y divided by r. Cos negative 116, it is supposed to be the adjacent divided by the hypotenuse, which is negative x divided by r. And tan negative 116 is supposed to be negative y divided by x, making tan the positive, while cosine and sine are negative. Then we go to negative 246, which we are getting y divided by r, cos is negative x divided by r, and tan is supposed to be y divided by negative x. And in this case, only sine is positive, while cosine and tan are negative, the second quadrant properties. Then we go to the first quadrant. You can be able to see all of them are positive. And in that case, all the trigonometric ratios are positive. Then we look at those that are greater than 360 degrees. You can be able to see I'm taking an angle 390. So it is going back to 360, subtract, get 30. So we get the trigonometric ratios of 30 degrees. And it is in the first quadrant. So the first thing, it is getting the anti-clockwise direction from 360 and get that angle. That is where 390 degrees is, as you can be able to see from the diagram. Assignment. Use the unit circle to the trigonometric ratios of, to find the trigonometric ratios of negative 222 degrees, negative 300 degrees, 800 degrees, and 1030 degrees. For more information, you can visit the KFB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, third edition. And also, if at all you want to contact us, you can get us from the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to your interview. Thank you.